started your thing.
I'm Esther, and I work for a local school district.
And my name is Larry, and I'm Esther's ex-husband.
We have a great son named Dave.
He's handsome, he's energetic, and he's fearless.
My ex-husband and I don't always agree on everything, but there is one thing we do agree on.
His girlfriend is a complete pain in the ass.
I'm hungry. I want my food now.
I better get my order right.
Where's our food? It's taking forever.
This is Dave. He's dating Cassandra. They've been going out for 3 months, and he thinks she's the perfect girlfriend.
Aw, baby.
But his parents disagree, so his mom and dad are each setting him up on a blind date. If you think Dave might have a problem with this, imagine how his girlfriend Cassandra will feel when she sits with his parents and they watch the dates together.
I can't believe this. This is up.
At the end of the day, Dave will have to decide which one he wants to keep seeing. His girlfriend Cassandra, or one of the new girls his parents have selected for him. Dave is about to experience parental control.
Hey, what's up? I'm Dave. I'm 21 years old. My girlfriend's name is Cassandra. She's a great chick. She's from the Midwest. She's beautiful. I have a really good time with her. I love taking care of Cassandra. She treats me great. I'm going to treat her great.
David loves to rescue women, and Cassandra is very needy.
She is high maintenance. That's not right.
You okay?
With Cassandra only working part-time, David tends to pay for everything. I think that Cassandra takes advantage of that.
He needs to get rid of the ball and chain, and he needs to play the field.
David needs somebody who isn't so insecure and a little more independent.
We're going to find him a new hottie.
Or a nice girl.
Hot.
Nice.
Now it's time for mom and dad to meet the potential blind dates.
Hi.
Hi. How are you?
Nice to meet you.
Tell me this, what do you do for a living?
I just quit my job so I can actually focus on school.
I am an office manager.
I'm a receptionist at a spa.
I do personal training.
I plan on getting a business major and taking over my mom's company.
I help out the Hurricane Katrina victims.
I'm a singer-songwriter.
I coach volleyball.
David's a volleyball player.
Yeah?
Yeah.
I love it.
I'm a Ruby's Diner waitress.
Get out of here.
Out of town.
Based on your looks, what do men assume about you?
A lot of guys think that I'm very into myself, that I'm easy and dumb because I'm a blonde, but I know that I'm not because I'm not.
I want people to think, oh, she's easy in the sack.
I've been told that I'm very intimidating.
That I'm very innocent.
I'm a really bad driver.
I may come across a little light, fluffy, and ditzy.
And that's an act.
Sometimes.
My ex-wife here wants us to find a really classy gal for our son, but I'd rather have one that's a little naughty. Could you read me a selection from this book? And could you do it in your sexiest voice for me? I know that won't be hard for you.
Really? You really want that?
He does.
Sheila entered Larry's tent like a wild cat in heat.
She was wearing a satin thong.
A shirt that held back two large firm breasts.
She freed them. They danced in the moonlight like two orphans on Sunday afternoon.
In his sleeping bag, Larry was making a tent of his own.
Oh, I get it. Her hands massaged his hairy chest. Ew.
As her moist mouth worked its way over his awaiting lips.
I'm sorry.
Oh, I don't blame you.
She stopped,
only long enough to whisper,
Larry,
before this night is through,
you will truly be a happy camper.
Whoa, it's working for me.
Oh my God. What is the thing that you and your ex-wife about most?
Who would drive?
And who would win?
I would.
Communication.
Because I thought school was important.
Cultural differences.
Me being too flirtatious.
He was really immature, so it was usually his fault.
Mainly my career.
It's tough on a relationship, huh?
Yeah. Would have liked him to walk me to my car once in a while in a dark neighborhood.
Well, how dark is it?
We're talking ghetto.
I like a guy who wants to go out with the guys, and I can go out with the girls.
I let you do that, didn't I?
I wouldn't remember.
If you were going to have cosmetic surgery, and from what I can tell, you really don't need me, but what would you have done and why?
You're not the one I'm dating, right?
No.
Honestly, I wouldn't have any done. Maybe later on in life. You never know, you change.
A little nip or tuck here or there, maybe later on?
Uh-huh.
Right. Have you had anything done yet?
No, I haven't.
I would like to be invisible.
Probably get a facelift.
I'd like better calves.
My nostrils, I think they're just too wide.
Guess every girl would say a boob job.
I feel disproportionate. I just want the hourglass figure.
Excellent choice.
What do guys think?
See, it's eye candy for guys. Why should we pick you?
So many reasons.
Because I'm nice.
Because I make up sandwiches.
I'm responsible, outgoing, fun.
I'm smart. You didn't ask me any intellect, but if you did, it would be there.
I have a great sense of humor.
I'm a fun and outgoing person.
He doesn't have to look after me because I can look after myself.
I'm adorable.
I'm different.
So you don't have one of those red maintenance lights on all the time?
No.
Okay, because there's a lot of those around.
Was that an attack?
No, because I'm very low maintenance.
Her light's broken. Thank you very much.
I won't be a fat wife. Thank you.
Nice to meet you.
Thanks, Angela.
She's a pistol. This is the one I want to choose.
I knew you'd go for that one. Oh. She's a handful, though. What do you think? Yeah. Can you handle this?
I'm not sure.
All right. I think I'm going to go for this one, the rocket ship.
I think that my girl's going to win. So
we'll see, won't we?
Yes, we will.
We'll see.
The date Dave's mom picked is about to arrive, and that means that Cassandra is about to watch her boyfriend go out with another girl while she hangs out in the living room with his parents.
Well, Dave, my girl's about to get here, and she's beautiful.
Smoking hot, let me tell you.
Do I have to worry? You might need to worry a bit.
You might need to worry a lot.
But when you go on these dates, you need to be respectful. I don't want any ass grabbing or anything like that.
Don't worry. You don't have to worry, honestly. Just don't worry about it.
There's my girl.
Wow, I hope you brought protection on this date.
What a skanky ass. This is up.
Tonight on Nick Cannon's Wildin' Out.
Gotta give it up for the fun.
We need each other.
Basis of passion.
Love is action. If you look.
Here's the deal. My parents do not like my girlfriend, Cassandra. So I'm here today to get set up on two blind dates. My mom's pick is almost here, and I hope she's hot.
Well, Dave, my girl's about to get here, and she's beautiful.
Are you excited, or?
She'll be smart, funny, you know, I'm sure she'll be good looking. My mom's got really good taste, so.
But when you go on these dates, you need to be respectful. I don't want any ass grabbing or anything like that.
Just don't worry about it.
There's my girl.
Hopefully it's somebody with class. Hi, Taylor.
Hi. I picked Taylor because David loves athletic girls. I think he's going to be very happy with my choice. Let's go see David.
Awesome. I want a tall, dark, handsome guy that treats me right, like can take me on. I'm always full speed ahead.
This is Cassandra. And this is my son,
Hi.
David.
Nice to meet you. I'm Dave.
Nice to meet you.
When I first saw that bitch walk in, I was about to jump up and rip that bleach blonde hair out of her head.
Well, let's go see if we can get you an upgrade.
Okay.
Do you call that an upgrade?
All right, see ya. When I first saw Taylor, I was like, holy cow. Her long legs, her blonde hair, she's definitely a hottie.
Dave and Taylor are about to head out for a dancing workout, while Cassandra tries not to get stripped down by mom and dad.
So, Cassandra, are you nervous?
Oh, no, not at all. We'll see David take out this bag of trash.
Okay, well, here we go.
Well, I'm gonna teach you some strip fitness today. Are you excited?
Strip fitness, huh?
Oh, my gosh. That is classy.
Good choice, Mom.
You got an awesome body. Do you work out?
Yes, I do. I feel like once or twice a week. Yes. How about you?
No.
Can I see your abs? Nice.
All right.
Keep your hands to yourself, Trashy.
We both look quite comfortable doing this.
Want to feel mine?
Yeah. Can you jingle that a little bit?
Yeah, definitely. Just got my new tattoo a week ago.
Oh, looks good.
I think I'm going to need a copy of this date for my private files.
That's sick.
I have a little surprise for you.
All right.
She's good at this.
Stripper school paid off, you guys.
Oh, she's perfect. How did you pick her? She should have been my pick. Going
down. Yeah.
She's not a whore. No.
It's even hard for me to watch.
I think I'm gonna need a cigarette after this date.
There's a little outfit in there.
Why don't you try it on and then show me some of your stuff?
All right.
Since you got to see mine.
Here, you can take this back.
Thank you.
There you are. Ooh, that scores points.
I am going to have a very long talk with your son.
Yeah, I think she's a nice girl. I really do. This is just another side to her.
David wants a woman, not a skanky little girl.
Woo!
Sexy. Definitely hot. What is he doing?
They're exercising. It's just exercising.
Well, I'm glad they've got you fooled.
So, next part of the date, you ready?
Yeah, I'm ready.
First, let's change and we'll go.
All right, okay. Let's go.
Awesome. So you have a good time strip dancing?
I had a great time. You look great.
Thanks.
Yeah.
What does she have to offer besides her body?
With that body, she doesn't need intelligence.
So you want to eat?
Yeah.
Looks good, because I'm hungry. What a skanky-ass whore.
Oh, I'm sure not.
We need a bib. You're drooling.
No, I'm not.
Well, I want to have just some honey right now.
Where do you want it?
You pick the spot.
Okay. I can do that.
Mmm.
I told him no kissing.
I hope he brought protection on this date.
I can't believe this. This is up.
That's better than the dancing.
I forgot to tell you I'm a good kisser, too.
Oh.
So is your girlfriend going to be mad about this kiss?
Well, I was just licking honey off you, I mean.
So you wouldn't do it again?
Oh, I'd do it again. I'll lick as much honey as you want me to lick, whenever you want me to.
She'll try anything.
Well, I had a great time today. I have a little souvenir for you. Mm-hmm. Maybe we could use another date.
Oh,
some
nice.
Some handcuffs from today.
It's gonna be a tough decision now. As long as I get some honey, too, if I pick you, right? All right, cool.
You might get some of that.
Awesome.
We'll see. She's not gonna pick her.
I think they might make a nice pair. I think they really connected.
And I'm gonna connect my fist to her face.
How's it going, guys? How are you, Cassandra?
Could be better.
Yeah?
How was your date?
I had a good time.
I thought I asked you not to kiss anybody.
That was part of the date. Just licked the honey off. It's all right. You're okay, right? Wow, I just got back from my date with Taylor. Note to self, more strip dates. It was great. So my dad's date is almost here. I can only hope that she's as hot as my first date.
Dave, wait till you meet the girl I picked for you. She is smoking hot. You won't believe it.
All right, cool.
Hopefully she's better than mom's choice.
I'm actually really excited to see who my dad picked.
There she is right now.
All right.
Let's see who dad picked.
Let's see.
This girl's so white, she's almost see-through.
They're enjoying themselves. I think they're having a great time.
Stop checking out the dancers.
Can I help it if I like coconuts?
Next time on The Shop.
Let's say hypothetically, all your life you came up short with the females. You get a couple $1 million, you're gonna get your joint fixed. Next thing you know, you could be a stud smashing everybody in Hollywood.
Busta Rhymes takes a seat.
When you get your hair cut out on the record?
Your mom's me.
My mom? That's my wife. Stepson. I had to step over him to get to his mother.
I love it. Yo, get bust out of here.
Being in a pool of credit card.
Here's the deal. My parents do not like my girlfriend, Cassandra. So they have set me up on 2 blind dates. Taylor took me to a strip fitness class. If you haven't done it, I highly recommend it. My dad's pick is almost here. He likes him wild and crazy, so I have no idea what to expect.
Hopefully she's better than mom's choice.
She is gonna take you places you've never been before.
Hopefully it's not too far away from me.
There she is right now.
Mm-hmm.
Let's see who dad picked.
Let's see.
Rebecca,
hi.
Come on in. The reason why I picked Rebecca is because she's not a ball and chain. David has a lot of energy and it's hard for him. He gets bored with her. after 5 minutes.
Come on in. Let's meet my son, David.
Okay. I don't drink. I don't do drugs because I am a trip, you know, without it, so.
Remember my ex-wife, Esther?
Hi, nice to see you again.
Nice to see you. Girlfriend, Cassandra.
Hi, how are you?
And this is my son, David.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
When I first saw Rebecca, the first thought that came to mind was, she looks like a 9-year-old. What is he going to do, take her to buy ice cream?
All right, well, you ready?
I'm ready to go.
I got some serious trouble planned.
Oh,
mm-hmm.
Trouble.
Yes.
All right.
Probably
see
not.
Mom? See Dad?
When I first saw Rebecca, I thought she looked gorgeous. She had beautiful hair. She seems pretty spunky and spontaneous, so I'm pretty excited.
Rebecca is taking Dave to the beach for a Hawaiian-style luau, while Cassandra tries to keep her head above water with Mom and Dad.
All right, you ready to see a classy Dave? I mean, wait till you see the one that I picked. She looks like she's got it going on, doesn't she?
Well, if you think Curly Sue's hot, I guess, yeah.
Wow, this is great.
All right. You like a drink?
Yeah.
We've got our own little tiki bar here for some tropical drink action.
Oh, I didn't know they made Raggedy Ann in life-size form.
She's cute.
I think she looks pretty hot.
This girl's so white, she's almost see-through.
So what do you do?
What I do, I am a parts manager at a boat dealership here in Huntington Beach. Mm-hmm. What do you do?
Well, you know, I personal train. And thank you very much. And yes.
You work out at like a gym or, okay.
Yeah, and see, I also work at a jazz club at night.
Well, that's cool.
Different she is. I mean, she's independent. She's living life large.
She's independent because nobody wants her.
Well, what is a luau without some dancers?
He's thinking, thank God for these dancers. I don't have to talk to her now.
They're enjoying themselves. I think they're having a great time.
Stop checking out the dancers.
Hey, can I help it if I like coconuts?
All right, so this routine we're going to teach you guys is called the mating dance. You're going to call your woman out. We'll just jump up like this. We go like this, all right? And she's going to come. She's going to
see-wee. Look at this seaweed hair weave, you guys.
Coming.
Well, he's being a good sport.
I think he's enjoying this date much better than your date.
This date's lame.
Right on.
All right.
She's got the pig call down pat, you guys.
She did do the pig call very well.
Now we get to have traditional Hawaiian.
Ooh. Aloha.
Aloha.
If this was a real luau, they'd put the apple in her mouth because she's a pig.
So, why don't your parents like your girlfriend?
She's pretty needy. She thinks I stare at every other girl in the world. Mm-hmm. It's not like I'm flirting with them.
No.
They think she's a little immature, I think.
You guys think I'm immature? From what I've seen, I'm more mature than he is.
Take over.
Great day, crazy time.
Yep. It's the end of the day. It's time that you should get laid.
Really?
Absolutely.
Awesome. I'm just kidding. You're cool.
Well, aloha, darling. Should we get you back?
Thank you. Let's go.
All right, baby.
I think that was a great date. I think Rebecca did a great job. Did you see her dancing in that grass skirt with all that crap in her hair? I mean, it was awesome.
If that's the best you two could do, I'm not worried at all.
This should be interesting.
It should be. And if he knows what's best, he'll choose me.
Hi, Dave.
Here you go.
Oh, no, it's okay.
No, are you sure?
I don't like seconds.
Did you have a good time?
I had an awesome time.
I learned how to dance, some seaweed.
I was proud of you. You made her squeal like a pig like I've never heard before. That was awesome.
You know what? That's how she's gonna call you to dinner. Sweet!
So I just got back from my date with Rebecca. We had a great time. She threw me a luau. I got laid. What a great chick. I got 3 ladies to choose from. This is not gonna be easy. I have no idea which one I'm gonna pick.
While Dave and his parents go over the 2 dates, Cassandra and the new girls are downstairs, anxiously awaiting his decision. Will Dave stay with Cassandra, a girl Mom and Dad think is a needy ball and chain, or will he take their parental control to heart and ditch her for one of the new girls?
This was a very hard decision for me to make. I had a great time with every single one of you. And my relationship so far with Cassandra, it's been great. Mom, I know why you picked Taylor. She's a gorgeous girl, and I really think she's got a great personality. Dad, I know why you picked Rebecca. She's very spontaneous, and she's down for anything, just like I am. And Cassandra, you're the queen of and you have an amazing heart, and I love that about you. But unfortunately, I have to eliminate someone right now. Rebecca, I had an amazing date with you, but I think we'd be better off as just friends.
But it was lovely to meet you.
It was nice to meet you.
All right, bye. Yeah.
I mean, nothing against Dave, but, you know, the dad picked me because, you know, he thought I could keep up with his son, but a chimpanzee on a tricycle could keep up with his son.
Taylor, you are super fun and very sexy. I had an awesome time with you. I'm a little bit worried, though, that you are a little bit of a player. And Cassandra, you're such an angel, and you have so much to offer me. But I'm a little bit worried because you're very needy. But I have made my decision. The woman I choose is... Taylor.
Woohoo! Welcome to the family.
Well, to be honest, I'm not really disappointed because somebody with such a big ego is lacking in other departments, if you know what I mean.
You know, as much as I hate to admit it, you made a great choice. She is a really neat girl. And I think in the end, we all won.
No, I won. She was my choice. Gotta bring out the home.
Thanks, Mom. Looks like they were right.
Touch it, bring it, pay it, watch it, turn it, leave it, stop, format it, touch it, bring it, pay it.